Okay, so Natsa Pusnik and I prepared an article about advertising on city buses. And as we all know, advertising is part of our lives. And vehicle advertising is one of the options for outdoor advertising. This means that the ads can be put on the buses, on the trucks, trains, cars, motorbikes, and so on. But why should someone advertise on the bus? Well, this type of advertising achieves high exposure. And according to the target group index, 29 million people in the UK are exposed to outdoor ads on buses every week. And here I would like to mention that the bus usually changes its daily lines. So in a few days, the same ad can appear in different parts of the city. And of course, the different percentage of the bus exterior can be covered. So the ad can cover the whole bus, including the windows, the doors, and the left side and the rear side of the bus are usually slightly different designs, the ads on this side, because they are more visible to the drivers. And the right side is usually more visible to the people who are waiting on the bus station. So our main interest was to investigate how many people can retrieve ads from their memory and what is their general opinion about outdoor advertising on the buses. So we prepared field and online survey, and we included 1,200 people. One half were obtained through a field survey and other half through an online survey. People were divided into 6 age groups, as you can see on the screen. So the first age group was up to 24 years old, and the oldest one were over 65 years old. Each age group consisted of 200 respondents, of which exactly 100 were female and 100 were male. The survey has 7 questions, but I will show you just some of the most interesting results. So our first question was, how often do you use the city bus in Ljubljana? And most people answered time to time, almost 40%, and 11% do not use city bus Ljubljana at all. And here is the chart, and the analysis by age groups among the respondents showed that people under the age of 24 most often use the city bus 4 to 6 times a week, and slightly less, 52, just to use the bus every day. In the remaining age groups, respondents most often use the city bus in Ljubljana occasionally. Well, this difference can be probably explained that young people go to high school or come to Ljubljana to study, so they are not employed yet and they cannot afford a car. So they used public transport more often than the other age groups. The second question was if they have seen an external ad on the bus in last week. Last week, of course, refers to the time of the survey. And most respondents, almost 82%, noticed at least one ad. But when we look at the graph, we can see that most 176 or 80% were in the first age group. The lowest number of ads was noticed by people over 65 years old. And 218 of all respondents didn't notice ads on the city bus in Ljubljana. So then we said, okay, you have seen an ad on the bus, but can you tell us which company was advertising? And yes, 18.8% people mentioned at least one ad, but here we can see that people under the age of 24 most often mention an ad, and the difference is quite big. So 34.5% in the first age group could mention an ad, and only 12% of those who are from 55 to 64 years old or over 65 years old. So the indication of ads with higher age group is declining. And on the screen, you can see the ad that was the most often mentioned. It is for school B2 and 18 people cited it. So as you can see, it covers the whole bus with this bright pink, which is the same as the logo. Logo is for school B2 on the glass with this smiling woman. It has a small amount of text, and this text is well visible even from the greater distance. The second ad was for windows and doors Kashgar. It was mentioned by 12 people. It also covers the whole bus. And this green color is the same as the color of the logo. Logo is here at least 8 times. Some of the text is visible from the distance. And some of the text, for example, this in bubble with men, it's only visible if you're standing on the bus station. The third ad was mentioned by 11 people. It's for Energetika Ljubljana, which means Electricity Ljubljana, so a company which provides electricity. It covers the whole bus, but it has no visible logo. Just on the second window is this Zvestoba Ogreva, which is one kind of slogan for this company. But this, the color of these lines are actually because Energetika Ljubljana is part of a public service, which includes also the taking care of garbage and plumbing system and everything. So every line is in one of the colors of this public service. And as you can see, this red dot also covers the glass. And the last one, it's a bit funny. It was mentioned by 9 people. And SWIT program is our national program for preventing colon cancer. So the ad has this illustration of people's backs, and this orange color is the same as the logo, which is on the right side with this funny illustration. And near the white car, you can see a slogan also for this program. So when we analyzed the most frequently mentioned ads, we found that they cover most of the bus. They are in vivid colors, and these colors are consistent with the corporate visual identity. And in most cases, they have small amount of text. In second part, we wanted to know how people feel about these ads. So we prepared some statements, and here is first. So ads on city buses are interesting. As we can see, people were here divided by thirds. So 32.3% told they don't agree or don't agree at all with this statement. 31.4% agree or totally agree. The most 36.3% respondents neither agree nor disagree with this statement. And here you can see the chart, and the majority, 27.5% of respondents who don't agree with the statements are from the age group 35 to 44, and the remaining age groups range between 15.5% and 21%. People under the age 24 most often choose the answer neither agree nor disagree. The second statement is that ads on city buses in Ljubljana are an unobtrusive way of advertising. The most common choice was do not agree or don't agree at all. 39.1% people have chosen that, but the difference between this answer and the agrees or totally agrees is only 2%. And the rest, 23.8%, neither agree nor disagree. And here we can see that 30.5% people under the age 24 and over 65 choose the option I agree with the statement, and similar were response of the age group 55 to 64. 6.5% of people age 35 to 44, 55 to 64, and over 65, so the last three age groups, choose the option, I totally agree. And the last statement, ads on city buses obstruct the view through the bus window. The analysis of the survey, field and online, showed that out of all statements about outdoor ads and city buses in Ljubljana, people most agree with this one, almost 65%, and 13.9% do not agree or don't agree at all, 21.8% the rest neither agree nor disagree. And 40.5% of those in first age group, 41.5% of those in second age group, and 40% of those in third age group fully agree that outdoor ads on city buses obstruct the view through the bus window. The least common choice was between 45 to 54 years old, 30%, and the least common choice option is to agree or disagree selected by the youngest one. Disagree most commonly choose age group between 45 and 54. And during this field survey, we heard some comments from respondents that because of these ads, they cannot see through the window, especially in bad weather or during the night, or if they don't know the location very well. So we said, okay, advertisers could maybe take this into account and avoid sticking ads on the glass surfaces, or maybe just put the posters on the top or on the bottom of it. But well, on the other hand, it turned out that people most often cited the ads that covered most of the bus site, including the windows. So here we should find maybe some solution. And just before I end, I would like to sum up. So first, it was found out that more than 80% of all respondents noticed at least one ad on the bus, and almost 19% remembered a specific ad. But here we need to add that the indication of ads with higher age group is declining, and the most frequently mentioned ads are cover most of the bars, are presented in vivid colors that also represent the corporate visual identity, and in most cases they have small amount of text. So in the future, maybe we could check how many of those who cited the ad later decided to buy this product, what is the cost of a company that advertised on city bus in Ljubljana, and how many new customers or users was gained because of this type of advertising. So thank you for listening. I hope this was interesting, and stay healthy.